Hello! Greetings. So this is going to be a Gorean video. Now, what I want to discuss today is the tendency of some, by no means all, because I know so many of those that I call Gorean reconstructionalists, that means people that try to live as close to the books as possible, as opposed to those that try to follow the philosophy as close as possible, that are such amazing people. But there are a few that, first of all, don't know what the philosophy is. Just being honest there, they have absolutely zero idea what a philosophy is. Just blindly following what's in the book, oh, but you can't do BDSM because look here what it says on page so and so and so. And then I say, yeah, what's the philosophical basis for this? What would be the reason? How does this relate to the author's own personal views? How does it relate to the philosophies that the Gorean ideas are built on? They say, oh, no, but look at this quote, it says such and such and such. Yeah, people, that's exactly the same as Christians do when they say, oh, but you can't do such because the Bible says that in such and such quote. You can say, how does this fit in? No, it says so in the Bible. That makes no sense. Here is the thing. I experience so often when I take up Gorean topics that people are more concerned with how I dress than with anything I have to say. And while I generally think that, well, their loss, it sort of shows a symptom among some Goreans. Excuse me for that sound, it's my cat having a bit of she's annoyed that she isn't getting attention right now. So, one of, basically, you can approach the Gorean books from one of two ways, or rather you can approach it from one of three ways. And I've discussed this in videos before. One is to look at the way people live in the books and only be guided by the fiction in the books and the way people live there and try to copy that as well as you can in a modern world. There's nothing wrong with that. That is perfectly fine. And then you have those that, and this is the category I belong to, where you try to look at the Gorean philosophy, the philosophy you find within the books. And generally then also the philosophies that the Gorean ideas are based on, because Norman didn't stick his hand as far up his ass as he could and just pull those ideas out. He is a teacher of history and philosophy. It's based on a lot of things, like, for example, Old Norse, a lot of Native American ideals, the Greek or Roman societies, the writings of Ayn Rand and her relativism, Nietzsche's ideas. You can also find a lot of it, while he doesn't cite Aleister Crowley as a source, you find so much of the same ideas within Crowley's works. Like, I encourage you, everybody who is Gorean that might watch this, go and read the Book of the Law by Aleister Crowley. And yeah, there's a lot of similar ideas. And those that are philosophers, Gorean philosophers, and then I don't mean people that are educated in philosophy, though some are that as well, but those that go by those philosophies, not everybody then decides to live as they do in the books. And there are a couple of reasons for that. First of all, A, since the Gore books are stories, you have world reduction, and that fiction cannot describe all of the world. The second thing is that it goes against the philosophies several times. And let me mention a few examples. Some of the city-states have the idea that if you are a lower caste, you should not ever have public office. Or there will be a big curse on the city. This goes directly 100% against the philosophies that are presented in the books, which supports a meritocracy. A meritocracy is based on your individual merits, not what family or caste you are born into. That would be an aristocracy. Another example could be the idea that no, if a free woman is only free as long as a man allow it. That also goes completely against the philosophies. And now a few of you are going to scream at me or type with your little fingers on the your keyboards. But the natural order! You are so horrible! You are so un-Gorean! How can you say this? Yeah, because here's the thing, there's a philosophy about freedom. Now, more men than women are naturally free. But the ideals of freedom doesn't change with whatever or not you have boobs. And the ideals of freedom is that to be truly free, you have to be willing to die to remain free. And within the books, there are women that are willing to die to remain free. And they are celebrated as the only true free women. So, yeah, that quote that everybody likes to tote around with goes 100% against the philosophy. And there's also a lot of quotes about everything from what to eat to, well, just about anything that doesn't really fit in or doesn't, it's just what a random character has said in a story. You can't read a book of fiction and just think that you will, that every quote contains the philosophy. To be able to sort out what has philosophical value and what is just there as fiction, you have to not only study the Gore books, but you have to study the philosophies that it is based on. So, yeah. And yes, absolutely. If I lived on Gore, I would not be wearing this. Among other things, because quite a few of my jewelry are plastic and it doesn't exist on Gore. And neither would I be talking to you through this computer, because having it would get me flame death. And I do not want to be put on fire. Though, as the priest kings kind of are a bit of an asshole, and there is one of the other parts. The whole priest king thing, bowing down to those gods. Yeah, that's what goes against the philosophy. The philosophy would be saying, oh, you are flame-deathing us? Well, fuck you, but guys. We are marching on your little hive there. Yeah, we are marching. And yeah, you can probably kill all of us before we get there, but at least then we will die fighting you assholes, so fuck you. That would be part of the philosophy. Bowing down and worshipping them, not so much. So, yeah, that is the thing about following a Gorean philosophy rather than the ideas that are found within the fiction of the books. Now, yes, the philosophy is there, but you have to be able to read between the lines, and to be able to do that, you need a general familiarity with the philosophies that inspired those books. And you also have to ask yourself when you see a quote, does this make sense? How does it fit in with the general philosophy? And no, it's there in a quote. That doesn't work as an answer. For example, I very often say this argument in the discussion about practicing BDSM while being a Gorean. And generally speaking, somebody then say, well, there's this quote here that says that while a Gorean master is will always be strict, he is seldom cruel, blah, 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 blah. And yeah, that's there. Now, there are a few things here to consider. What is cruelty? Before we call something cruel, we might want to define for ourselves what is cruelty. Because that isn't defined. And yeah, so if two people just happen to think that playing spanky butt is the one thing that really spice up their love life, how is this cruel really? Is it that physical pain is always cruel? So let's say that you're a slave and you get you need to have an operation. So your master takes you to the hospital, you get an appointment, you have an operation. The recovery from that operation is painful. Is it cruel? What if your master decides that, you know what, we are going to get into shape. So we are going to go for a long walk every day. And you're kind of out of shape. And so that walk that really gives you quite a bit of a burn, is it cruel? What if you happen to like heavy exercise, you really like to run until you really feel that burn? Are you cruel? What if you decide to go and get a tattoo? Are you cruel to yourself? You need to define what is cruelty. You need to use your head to think. And that is the problem with quote thumping. Whatever it not, it's quote thumping among Gorians, or it's quote thumping among somebody who is religious. It generally means somebody does not want to think. Now, don't get me wrong. Quotes can be a great way to get a snapshot into the philosophies. I'm not saying that anybody who posts a quote, who mentions a quote, or anything like that, isn't thinking. I'm saying that when that is your by-all and all. So I really, really want to play spanky, but the book says that the Gorean master is seldom cruel, so I can't be a Gorean and like playing spanky, but then something is wrong here, because then you have to ask yourself, why is that quote there? And then having a look at the at philosophies that are surrounding this to figure out, yeah, where do we place this? Now, let me try to explain this one. First of all, you have to look at surrounding philosophies. And a lot of surrounding philosophies, you have had BDSM activities. It was extremely common within the Roman Empire. It's so common that of the various paintings and bits of scrolls, basically what we have, there's a lot of sexual practices mentioned. A lot of them is BDSM related. The Romans were kinky fucks. And that, the Greek or Roman ideals is probably the biggest foundation for the Gorean philosophies. So historically, no. You also have to look at the author's other works, such as, for example, Imaginative Sex, where John Norman several times says that he doesn't like pain play. It's not a thing that turns him on. And In the pain play situations within his book, he have the sub being padded so that you can have the spanking scene without any pain being caused. That doesn't mean it's fit into some philosopher, because we are not following what turns John Norman on. That's not the thing. Of course, if you want to follow that, so John Norman is the new savior, we will follow John Norman. Go ahead, whatever makes you happy. But generally speaking, if you're a Gorean philosopher, that's not what you're going for. You're going for that particular philosophy. So there's a reason why the author would put that in there. That has nothing to do with the philosophy itself. So yeah, that there you have a little bit of an explanation why that's there. Another thing is that he speculates that on a world such as Gore, the desire to be a sadist or the desire to be a masochist would be much rarer, because these are symptoms of a world that is out of order. And that might be, it can quite possibly be that he is right about that. But we live in a world that's out of order. So that by these philosophies, if kink is your thing, denying yourself that is actually what's against the philosophies, which says to be true to yourself. And not actually researching why and just looking at the quote. The quote says that. That is something else. No, of course, if you want to be a reconstructionalist, a pure reconstructionalist, then you would want to look at every quote, you will follow things as closely as you possibly can. And that's fine too. What I have a problem with is when reconstructionalist points at people that are not reconstructionalists and says, you're not Gorean because you are not following all of these quotes. You are doing research and deciding which ones are relevant from a philosophical point of view and which one is just part of the fiction or part of John Norman's own point of view. And that can be a bit irritating now and then. So, yeah. I think that it's important to, first of all, before you say you follow a philosophy, learn what a philosophy is. Because I meet so many Goreans that say, oh, I follow the Gorean philosophy. I say, yeah, okay, but what's the Gorean philosophy to you? Well, it is women being the slaves of men. That is not a philosophy. Oh yeah, and then we follow the quotes of the books. Yes, still not a philosophy. You're not a real Gorean. Here's the thing. Read up on what a philosophy is. Read, actually, the Gore books. Don't just go quote hunting on the internet. Read books about the other sources of similar philosophies, especially those that inspired John Norman. And then look at quotes, look them as a valuable source of information, but don't worship them. Decide for yourself whether or not that quote makes sense. And there's a hell of a lot of them that don't. So yeah, being a Gorean philosopher is more than just quote thumping. And I think that's what I wanted to say with this long rant. So yeah, I hope you have enjoyed this video. I know some of you haven't. So get typing with your little hate messages. I love them. I eat them for dinner. So yeah, have a great day and blessed be.